Good morning, students. Welcome back. Today, we are going to learn a very important topic, that is abolition of slavery. Slavery was a common practice in France. Now, in today's topic, we are going to learn what happened to this practice of slavery after the French Revolution. Now, why we are learning this? Because French Revolution stands for equality, fraternity, for human right, equality of human beings. Then what about this slavery? Yes, students. Even after the French Revolution, the practice of slavery continued in France. And this was really very pathetic. Slavery, the slaves were not given equal rights, basically in the French colonies. So let's see about this topic. The most revolutionary social reform of the Jacobin government was abolition of slavery. It means the convention government abolished the slavery, but after the French government, the National Assembly government was formed, and that National Assembly government continued the practice of slavery. In fact, the colonies in the Caribbean countries, some of the Caribbean countries, means the countries of West Indies, some of the Caribbean countries were under the control of France. They were French colonies. Like Martinique, Guadeloupe and Saint Domingo, these island countries were under the control of France, and they were the French colonies. And in these French colonies, basically the commercial agriculture, that is the plantation agriculture of tobacco, indigo, sugar and coffee, was basically done. And in these islands, the European laborers, whether the labor from France, England, or from any country, no European laborers were ready to go to these island countries to work as a labor in these plantations. As a result, these plantation owners were having a great shortages of labor. But the plantation workers, they had to continue because these were the commercial crops and they had a great demand in the international market. So they started collecting the slaves, and there was a triangular slave trade. Yes. A triangular slave trade was established between Europe, Africa, and America. This triangular slave trade supplied the slaves to these plantation for doing plantation agriculture. The slave trade began in 17th century, and the French merchants sailed from the ports of Brodex and Nantes to the African coast, where they bought slaves from local chieftains. Branded and shackled the slaves, they were packed these slaves tightly into ships for a 3-month long voyage. Voyage means sea journey across the Atlantic and reached Caribbean. And in these Caribbean island, they were sold to the plantation owners. The exploitation of slave labor made it possible to meet the growing demand in European market for sugar, coffee and indigo. Means they were basically used as plantation workers for producing all this commercial crop. And I am telling you, students, there were port cities like Brodex and Nantes I have already written Broadex and 90s. These port cities were economically prospered, you know, for what? For a flourishing slave trade. So slave trade was going on continuously in France and in French colonies even after the French Revolution. The revolution which was meant for equality, fraternity, etc. So what after that? We will continue with this.